Today we are going to talk about if you should get a master's degree in engineering. I will discuss two scenarios as well as give examples from my own experiences. Hi everyone, my name is Adriaan. I'm a mechanical engineer and I create video content on a broad range of engineering topics. If it's your first time here, welcome. If you like what you see or are just plain entertained, do consider giving this video a thumbs up. All right, let's get into it. So I did my master's right after I finished my bachelor's in mechanical engineering. When you consider doing your master's degree in engineering, most of the times you will fall into two categories. Category one, you know exactly what you want to do after university. And category two, you are still unsure on what you want to do after university. Now, I fell in that category. Now, which category do you see yourself in? Let me know in the comments below. Let's discuss each category and why or why not you would consider doing a master's in engineering. Category one, you know what you want to do after university. When you know what you want to do after university, you will know if a master's degree is required for the position that you want to end up in. Positions like this can range from research positions at universities or R&D companies, which most of the times require you to have a master's degree or even a PhD to work there. Or another position is a principal or lead design engineer, which can require you to have a master's degree in order to qualify for the position. But those positions most of the time also require you to have quite a lot of experience, so you won't be able to go into that role right after university. Now, if you want to go into a research position, then the short answer to this whole video is yes, get a master's degree because you won't be considered for that position if you don't have a master's degree or higher. On the other hand, if you want to become a lead or a principal design engineer, then there are a few things that you need to take into consideration. The first thing you need to consider is, do you have the time to continue studying and the money to pay for your master's degree? If you want to get your master's degree over and done with right after you've completed your bachelor's, the chances are quite good that you have to pay for it yourself. And this can be circumvented by looking at companies that are willing to sponsor you or give you a bursary. But those chances are fairly low because a lot of companies won't invest that money if they don't really know if you are worth it. On the other hand, if you know where you want to end up and which company you want to work with, you can actually inquire to see if they've got some sort of scheme that you can apply to for further studies. This can be in the form of full financial support or partial financial support. They might even allow you to go back full-time studying, or you'll be required to do it part-time. Now, this brings me to my personal experience. I got a bursary in my second year of my studies, which required me to work the bursary off after I've completed my bachelor's. The people that gave me the bursary was a power utility, and I really enjoyed working there, and I got really interested in nuclear power generation. The nuclear power plant that the utility ran required you to actually have a master's degree in order to qualify for a position there. So ultimately, for me to get a role there, I had to get a master's degree. The company actually had a scheme which you can apply to, and then they would pay for your studies as well as send you back to university full time. Unfortunately, I missed the application date and I had to settle for a part-time route instead. I did not end up going to work for the nuclear power plant, but during my master's, I realized how much I enjoyed doing research. And I used my master's to apply to a research position at a university, and I've been enjoying myself ever since. Category two, you are unsure on what you want to do after university. Now, on the other side of the fence, we have people like me, before I got my bursary, that didn't really know what I wanted to do after university. Questions such as, should you go and work after you've completed your bachelor's, or should you stay and do your master's because it might be beneficial, were mingling in my head at the time. Now, if you are unsure what you want to do after university, I would suggest not doing a master's straight after finishing your bachelor's because you might not even need one. I would say go work a bit, get a feeling for the industry, and at a later stage, you can decide if a master's degree is required for the route that you want to take in your professional career development. And if you can get to the point you want to be at in your career without the requirement of a master's degree. Next, we need to talk about professional registration. I've come across quite a few engineering roles which require you to be professionally registered as an engineer. Now, in the UK, you need a master's degree in order to register as a chartered engineer. While in South Africa, you only need an accredited bachelor's degree to register as a professional engineer. Let's look again at my past experiences. If I stayed at the power utility in South Africa, I could have registered as a professional engineer without the need of a master's degree and applied to become a senior engineer at the power utility. I could even possibly have become an engineering manager if the position came open, again, without needing a master's degree. So for that career path, a master's degree would have been unnecessary. On the other hand, if I was a design engineer in the UK, in order for me to progress in my career, I have to register as a chartered engineer, and that would have required me to have a master's degree in engineering. Now, I could have done my master's degree right after I finished my bachelor's degree to get it done and over with, or I could go work a bit, gain some experience, and then go do my master's degree with or without the financial support of my employer. And after I got my master's degree, I can then register as a chartered engineer and progress in my career development. Ultimately, you need to look at your situation. Do you know where you want to work after university? And does that role require a master's degree? Do you have the time and money to complete a master's degree now? Or is there a possibility for your employer to pay for your further studies? And in your career progression, do you need to become professionally registered? Do you need a master's to get professionally registered? And if so, is your situation such that you can do your master's degree right after university? Or will you be able to do it later with the financial support of your employer? Good luck in your decision. I hope I cleared away some uncertainties. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.